This is the next talk on Reduce Curve Node. We start with the source curve sketch. I used it yesterday too. Now I display the workflow with a lot of other methods here. I unhide my tool and I see it here. I hide this, the reference sketch. Here is the result of the reduced curve work. And the first thing what we have is we have different strategies. First thing is I use here the strategy center of mass. That means when I have here the yellow subcurve, I can calculate the center of mass of the poles of this one. And now this point is placed at this position where the center of mass is. And now I can calculate the new curve, and one pole is located in this point. I made this yesterday, and I can now switch to other algorithms. Another algorithm is that I want to flow the curve through a point. So I use the point mode, and when I calculate, I get this, and now the curve goes through this point. And this point is the, in default, the center of mass of the old poles. But now I can use here some tracker to move this point a little bit. And what we see is that the solution, the curve, follows this point. So it's always possible to reduce a subcurve consisting of some segments to a simplified curve which goes to this point, and the point is here. If I want to use not for this point the center of mass of the poles, but an absolute value, I can switch here, use position as absolute, and in this case this position is now in the real world space, and I can display it here. I replace the coordinates by the origin, and I see now the red curve goes through this point, and now I can change the values. And I get these results. So we always have the problem if we have only a segment which has to go through one point, that we get sometime unexpected results. So the calculation is done with a SkyPy optimize method, and I can select here different algorithms to calculate the solution. Maybe that one of these algorithms is very slow or does not give us the expected results, so we can switch. It's the same like the workflow in Sketcher. The other strategy we have here is the strategy find the shortest segment. If I use this, now a curve is calculated which is the shortest one from this point to this point by modifying one pole. So if we have larger segments, then always the shortest is something like a straight line from one to the other one. The only problem we have here is that we have to consider the tangent constraints. That means here at first the curve has to follow the tangent, and then it can go the shortest way and come back to this place. When I have calculated here such a solution, I can use these two sliders to move it a little bit around. Okay, and at the end I now can commit my result, and I also can bake the result. Baking means that I have here a shape which is fixed, which is a well-defined solution, and I can do this more times. So I go here to another place and calculate other segments and commit them and bake them. And so I have in this case first solution. I hide my tool. I hide this. So we have this solution, this one, and then we have this one. So I can collect a lot of solutions and can reuse them. The only thing is the baked shape is always non-parametric, is like a simple copy in part.